Hi, everybody, and welcome to episode 70 of the This Old Knit podcast. I am your host, Nina, otherwise known as Ine on Ravelry, Instagram, and Pinterest. And you can find show notes for this episode and many other episodes on the Ravelry thread for each separately numbered episode. So how have you all been doing? It has been a long, long time. I think 3 or 4 weeks since I podcast last, and a lot has happened. There's several reasons for the long hiatus in podcasting, one of which is that I was very, very sick for about a week. for those of you who follow me on Instagram, you already saw many posts from my bed, and for those who do not, I had a sinus infection, bronchitis, and double eye infections. So I was on antibiotics, various forms of decongestants, and a separate antibiotic for my eyes. So I'm all better now. The kids got things after I did, so Joshua got some kind of stomach virus, and then he got an ear infection, so he's still finishing his course of antibiotics, and now Megwin has been dealing with kind of upper respiratory stuff, which the doctor suspected was viral, but I think she has an ear infection now too, so she's going to go to the doctor tomorrow. So I am ready for it to be spring and for all of this crap to go away. We've had our windows open the last 2 days, but it is pouring rain today, so I could not have the windows open anymore, but it was very nice just to air the house out, and I've slowly been taking it back from the chaos that happens when I'm down for a week. I did not leave my bed, basically. I came home from a work event on Friday, and I went and laid down, and I really didn't leave my bed until the following Sunday, other than to go to the bathroom, obviously, make cups of tea, which I had constantly going, and to go to the doctor after I'd been sick for 5 days and just couldn't take it anymore. you can tell I'm still a little bit breathy. Bronchitis takes a really long time, I feel like, to really truly recover from, just because you do a lot of damage with all of that coughing, so it takes time. So my voice is a little bit gravelly, but I assure you I do feel a million times better than I did. So, long-winded introduction there. One other thing that happened the previous week when I was supposed to record my last podcast is that my Aunt Lynn passed away, and she was a very avid knitter and crocheter. She was on Ravelry as Lynn, L-Y-N-N-C-A. I don't know if my mom has yet contacted Casey to, I think you can have the profile switched over to being like an angel profile. But yeah, so she was active in the community, and she will be greatly missed. But I do have some things I will show you this week and probably over the next several weeks that came from her stash. So my mom and my sister and I divided up what we wanted to keep, and then the rest my mom took to her knitting group so that they could also have something to remember her by. And we had a memorial service for her, and it wasn't really a service per se, because we didn't really have anybody speaking or anything like that, but we just had like all of her different various things she had made, just some examples of her work spread around, and then we had two pretty decent sized knitting group circles, which was really nice. So so we just kind of sat around and knitted and chatted and remembered about her, and it was very nice. So I am going to run out of memory, actually, so give me just a minute and I'm going to clear off some stuff. Okay, everybody, we're going to try one more time. I was trying to record on my phone, and it seems to be doing some weird stuff. I don't know why. My camera was also doing a little bit of weird stuff. But anyway, here we are. So, Aelin passed away. I got some of her stuff, so I will show that to you in a little bit. So on to other things, and I'll talk more about what else I've been doing in the end of the podcast in case you are not interested. Our cows are wrapping up, so we have two cows going right now. We have the palate cleanser cow and, rocking on some plastic. The palate cleanser cow and the honey pullover cow. So the honey pullover cow ends at the end of March, and the palate cleanser cow does as well. So I have actually got a few things for prizes. And where did I put those? Okay. So for one of them, probably the palate cleanser cow, I picked up an extra set of these stitch markers from Sugar Tots. So they are some little eggs, kind of in different gemmy type things. I think they fit up to a US 9 or US 10 needle. And then a little Notions pouch from the No Makers website. So it's kind of that recycled, like grocery bag material. So those two will be one of the prizes. And then I still haven't picked out for the honey pullover cow. I was gonna do some yarn from my stash. I haven't picked that out yet, but I will make sure that I pick that out, obviously, before the next episode. And when I draw winners, I'll let you know. And then my plan was to do one prize from all of the chatting from the palate cleanser cow, and then one prize. I'll just go through and look at all of the finished object posts that have a picture. Because you can sort by images for different threads, and I will pick a winner also from all of the finished objects, because I didn't set up a finished objects thread because I am a slacker. So I'll do that, and then I will come up with a prize for one of the people that has a finished object. So if you've just been chatting along, you also have a chance to win as well. Because that one was supposed to be really laid back. So, finished objects. Obviously, since it's been several weeks, I have several finished objects. And I was sick. So while I was stuck in bed that whole time, really all I could do was knit and read. So I read through all but the last book of the Harry Potter series. And I knit a lot of stuff. And I watched a lot of podcasts. And I listened to a lot of audio podcasts, and I watched a lot of Netflix. So first up, I did a pair of mittens for Megwin, which it is, of course, getting warm, so she probably will not get a whole lot of use out of them, but that's okay. I did make them a little bit large, so fingers crossed they will fit her next winter as well. So here they are. What I did is I used some leftovers from, I did one of the 99 row Shawlettes by Susan B. Anderson for my husband's grandmother. And then I had left over some Malabrigo Rios in, I don't know, some purple color. And so I wanted to hold that double with a mohair blend yarn. So I was able to get one mitten complete. And then I think I got to roughly here, and I realized I didn't have enough to complete the mittens. So I ripped back on this hand, and then I added in this tan color. So this is actually a camel colored yarn, and I believe it's an alpaca wool blend. So I did that, held with the mohair, and then I topped it off with a little bit of the purple. So I did that on both of the mittens. And then I used the camel color and the purple to make stripes on the thumbs to kind of pull it all together. So I'm really pleased with how they turned out. Megwin really likes them, and she said she likes the fluff. And they're very warm. I used the World's Simplest Mitten Pattern by Tin Can Knits. and I believe a size 7 and 6. So I did 6 for the ribbing and size 7 for the hands, and they're just child size. So I actually just tried them on Megwin and kept knitting until they fit her. So they're definitely custom for her. So that's finished object number one. And then finished object number two, you never saw this one cast on either. So if you remember the last podcast, I asked which shawl I should cast on next. I had a couple of choices and a couple sets of yarn. So I decided to cast on for the Spotlight Shawl by Janine Kaleo, I think is the name. And I've had this one in my queue for a really, really long time. So I used two yarns. They're both singles base. This one is Oslo Micro Diary. And I forgot to bring the tag. It's a really long name. It's basically she snorted the magic beans and woke up in a Technicolor world, I think. So that's the multicolored one. And then it goes into this really nice striping section to blend the colors together. And then this nice lace section. So I have not blocked this. You can tell by the fact that the lace is curling up like crazy. But this other colorway is the Yarn at Home Mom in the Vicious Trollop colorway. And it is a Gilmore Girls reference. So I really love this pink. And I definitely want to get more of it. So this guy is super stretchy. So it is my entire arm span without even really blocking at all. So I know it's going to be a nice big shawl. It's very warm and cozy. And so that's kind of how you'd wear it. You'd wear it with the lace point down. So yeah, once I block it, I'll show it again. And you can see how it changes. But I am going to enter this in the 13 Months of Magic Cal for Jilly from the Knitting Broomstick podcast. And I think that's the only one. I was thinking about doing it in the Inside Number 23 Harry Potter along, but I don't know if I'll do that or not. Okay, so that is finished object number two. Finished object number three, I do not actually have with me. The reason for that is that it was something for my husband, so I made him a scrubby washcloth out of Lion Brand Scrubby yarn. It's kind of like this. It's 100% polyester or nylon, and it's like a scrubby sponge. And so I just did Grandma's favorite washcloth. It's the weirdest yarn I've ever knit with. It didn't hurt my hands, and he really likes it, but it's already, you know, been used for washing dishes and stuff, so it's not very pretty. But I will insert a picture here. And you can see what it looks like. Yeah, I had a lot of fun with that one. That one was quick, maybe took me like an hour. And he really likes it, so I'm gonna make another one. It took maybe half a ball of that yarn, so I have enough to make another one. So yeah, I'm pretty happy about that. And yeah, that's my last finished object. So whips, I have my honey pullover, and it is almost done. It would have been a finished object today, but I really wanted to take the chance to podcast while I could. So next time it will be a finished object, and I will have it done in time for the cow. But I will show you where I am now. So I have it in my super sweet bag from Coddington. And yep, there it is. So I have done it in two colors of Woolen Vine yarns. The green is Venus Flytrap on her blitzed base, and the multicolor is I Will Always Find You on Volca. I alternated two skeins for that one. And you can see I have one pocket completely done, and I just have to finish the second pocket. And then I need to tack the pockets down and weave in all my ends. But otherwise it is done. So I did 3/4 sleeves. So they come to about here on my arm, which is a really great length. It fits perfectly. I will go into more details of all of the stuff I did when I have it as an actual finished object and it's all blocked, and I'll talk through what exactly I did with it, because I had a lot of modifications I did. I knit several sizes, so this is a Franken-knit piece in every sense of the word. And yeah, but I really am happy with it. I hope that I can get to wear it a little bit before it turns to summer. I have a feeling that we're gonna have a very short spring and it's gonna go right to being hot, because we barely had a winter. We had maybe 2 snows that were anything to speak of this year. So it was a really disappointing winter. But whatever. Okay. Next whip. I am working on the first of the New York Sock Club patterns by Mina Philip. This one is called the Grand Central Socks. So this is what they will look like. And I do not have very much of this done at all. So I'm knitting it out of Hedgehog Fibers in Fool's Gold, which I bought for myself for my birthday because yellow is my favorite color. And believe it or not, I have no yellow socks. It's my favorite color, but I don't have any yellow socks. That's crazy. So here's the tiny, tiny bit that I have. Just a little cuff. But I do love how it's knitting up. I love the little speckles and everything that makes Hedgehog Fibers totally fun. I am probably going to lose light pretty soon. So that is another whip. And then yet another whip. I'm not actually working on that many things actively right now. This is my last whip, because I knit some on my beekeeper's quilt. So I cast on for another sweater. So if you remember, I said this was going to be the year of the sweater for me. So I'm trying to do this for the Green Gables cow, but I'm not going to get it done because that ends at the end of this month too, and it was crazy sauce to try to do a second sweater, but hey, I'm a crazy person. So, what I did is I cast on for the French Toast Pullover by Alicia Plummer. And it is using this, really the first indie dyed yarn that I ever got a sweater quantity of. So this is Gaia's Colors. The base is called Mama Quilla Worsted. And she named all of her colorways for gods and goddesses. So this one is Folta, which I guess is an Irish, like fertility goddess or earth goddess. So it's this lovely shade of green. It's obviously kettle dyed, so it is tonal. And the French Toast is just a normal raglan pullover with a cable down the front. So I have got to just at the probably largest point of the bust. Let me see if I can spread this cable out a little bit for you to see it. So there's the cable. So I am very, very clearly alternating skeins because this is a very tonal yarn and there is a lot of variation between the skeins. So there's the back. You work short rows for the neck part and it's kind of comes down in the front. So I've never done that before, short row shaping for the back of a neck, and I do really like how it looks. It looks a little rough right now because this is a slight bit of thick and thin. It's a single as well, or a single space as well. So it looks really good once it's been blocked. I did do rather a large swatch, and it blocked out very, very smooth, but while it's being knit, it's pretty rough. And on it, I also got another set of stitch markers because I realized I don't have very many stitch markers that will fit on larger needles, and I didn't get gauge till I went up to a size 9 US. So I bought a set of Harry Potter stitch markers. And these are from the Knitty by Nature shop. So I have a Quidditch broom, the sorting hat, a tie, a little ink bottle and quill, and there should be one more. No, maybe not. Oh, and the owl progress keeper. And I also bought a prize to donate for Jillie's 13 months of Magic House, so I got to send that along to her. And she can enjoy that, giving it away. But it's a very fun knit. I'm really, really enjoying it. My picture's in black and white, but that's what the central cable looks like there. Go check it out. It's a very pretty sweater. And it's a very straightforward pattern. So yeah. Now that I'm done with my honey pullover, I will be able to make a serious dent in that. And yeah, if I don't cast on a million more things, because I do want to cast on another shawl. So I am going to share the yarn for my next cast on, and then I'll take a little break and I'll come back with acquisitions. So I really, really love all the shawls I'm seeing from Helen Stewart's MCAL for the Snowmelt shawl, and I think it was Danny's from the Little Bobbins podcast. I follow her on Instagram and I saw her completed shawl and I was like, oh, I want one. She did hers in kind of more muted tones, which is very much her aesthetic. So I knew I had wanted to put these two yarns together. This one is Madeline Tosh Merino Light in the rose colorway. I got this from my mom for Christmas. And then this one is Franco Phoenix in the macaroon colorway. So it's lots of pastels of different macaroon colors. But I didn't know what to pair with these two. So I was chatting with Kristen from the Yarngasm podcast, and I was thinking Angry Orchard, just sort of a peachy color. And I didn't feel quite like that was the thing. And then I said, well, I have that eggnog from No Makers that I got at Christmas. She was like, yes, do that. So when I got home, I put them together, and they definitely need to be together. So it is a perfect match. So that will be my Snowmelt shawl, which I will cast on when I finish my honey pullover. It is currently holding both of my shawl needles because I usually knit my shawls on a size 5 needle, and both of my size 5s were on my sweater, which is probably a good thing because it kept me from casting on something I didn't need to be casting on when I needed to finish my sweater. So these get to be on my needles, yay! So I'm going to wind these up today when I finish podcasting, and I will cast on for that tonight. So that's pretty fun. I'm excited. So I'm gonna take a little break, eat my food, and then I will be back. Okay. So acquisitions. I have quite a few because I didn't share some of them last time, and I have received some things since then. So I participated in the January, February club from Yarn Enabler, and there were two choices. You could either pick the sangria choice or the white wine choice, and it was like either kind of more bold, bright colors or more muted colors. So I chose the white wine choice. So there were two parts to it. There was a pencils part. So this is my pencil skein. So you get the two mini skeins that have the eraser and the little metal band around it. Get two mini skeins that'll be the wood part and the lead. And then a full skein that is the pencil itself. So this one is kind of a variegated pink. And the name of it is First Love. And I really like it. I'm gonna try to get two pairs of pencil socks out of it. One pair for me and then one pair for Megwin. So I think she'll get a kick out of having pencil socks. And then there was a mystery variegated skein that came with it as well. So this is the one that I got. Sorry, there's a lot of glare now because the sun is coming out right before it goes down for the night. So it's a lot of variegated pastels. The name of it is Sweet Kisses. And I'm thinking that this actually might make a really great honey sweater for Megwin, paired with a gray. So I'm thinking maybe Poe from Full and Vine Yarns. That's what I think I'm gonna do with that one. And then I actually got the club skein for the second installment of the Mystery Sock Yarn Club from Full and Vine. That came yesterday. So I got it on the Sparkle, and it is this beautiful, beautiful skein. The name of it is Gatekeeper. So it's almost like a rainbow overwashed in black. That's what I think of it as. It's a Kristen rainbow. This, like I said, on her blitzed base, so you can see the sparkle. It's very pretty. Excuse me. And then I won a giveaway from the Yarn at Home Mom. So it was for the first installment of her Outlander based sock club. So it is this set. There's a little bit of glare from, again, that sun. It is called Lady of Lollybrock, this skein. And then this contrasting color for heels, toes, and cuffs is in the Sage colorway. Here's the other side of it. So it's just tons of speckly goodness in there. So I may try to knit this for Jilly. Is co-hosting an Outlander cow, I think, with Stitching the High Notes podcast. So yeah, I might try to make some socks out of that. I don't know yet though. I'm pretty overcommitted at this point, like you do. And then this was the big guy that came last time, and I saved it just because I had so many things that I was sharing that this was not going to get its due. And so I wanted to show it this time, and it is from Pandia Jewels. I got the Star Wars edition. She was putting together kits for the Find Your Fade shawl. Now, I am not going to make a Find Your Fade shawl because I think it's just way too large for me and the shape of it. I probably wouldn't wear it. So I am actually going to make a sugar maple tea. I'm going to make a sugar maple tea out of this yarn. And then whatever I have left, I will use for shawls or socks or things like that. So it is 7 skeins. And it was for the price of 6. And they are all Star Wars inspired colorways. And I love Star Wars. So... Eek, it's so pretty. And really, I wanted it for, there's a couple of skeins here that she's not going to carry again. And she dyed them when Carrie Fisher passed away, based on Leia's character. and I really had to have those. So the only way to get it was to get this whole thing, and I am not complaining at all because they're all beautiful. So from left to right, this one is when you try to rescue your boyfriend and end up a slave girl on Tatooine. This one is one in a million shots, still crash land on Dagobah. This one is You're My Only Hope. This one is Chewie, Hit the Hyperdrive. Yes, Megwin?
I can't fly away through my obstacle course because I keep getting shoot by Sandman.
Bummer. This one is Drowned in Moonlight. This one is Thought I Found a Safe Spot, Ended Up in Carbonite. And this one
What's
is
Carbonite?
It's the stuff that Han gets stuck in the scene when they freeze him in carbonite.
Yeah, right.
And this one is Dark Lord of the Sith dies falling down a shaft. I love her colorway names. So that's going to make a really amazing butter sugar maple tea. And then, like I said, I might just take this one out completely and use it on its own for a shawl.
Okay, so I put something to his pot for he'll shoot.
Okay. And then I got some bags just for storing my stash. No Makers was having a really great sale of, what was it called? Like Storage Tuesday or something like that, where she did 50% off of all her bags. So I got four of these guys, which are like clear vinyl with these really nice straps. And look at how much I fit in there. This is basically all of my indie dyed sock yarn stash, aside from my woolen vine and my No Makers, because they have their own baskets. But this is kind of everyone else. And there's some cedar in there too. And it's not even really as packed as it could be. I could probably shove some more in here if I wanted to squish them a little bit. Isn't that awesome? So I got four of those, and I can fit them two side by side on my shelving, my IKEA shelving. So I'm really excited about those. And they ended up being like $6 a piece, so very affordable. And then last but not least is some yarn from my Aunt Lynn. So I had to wash all of it because it had been sitting in storage for quite a while and there was some moth damage. But I did like the vinegar rinse and making sure I froze it. So I've only gotten through, I think, three sweater quantities so far. I still have a really huge like comforter bag of stuff, and I'm slowly like rescanning it because she had everything balled up, I think, because mom said she didn't have a ball winder, so whenever she bought yarn she always had it wound in the yarn store or had my mom wind it up. So I have to skein everything and then wash it, dry it, freeze it, dry it before I can put it away. So it's quite a process. So anyway, she had a lot of Madeline Tosh, a lot. I got two sweater quantities of Madeline Tosh yarn, and one of them is this one. So this is Spectra. Spectra. And you will see over time that my Aunt Lynn really loved like blues and kind of that purpley blue color. This one is just a single skein. I don't know what it is either because it wasn't labeled, but it's really pretty. So this one will probably become a hat. Sorry, Megwin's playing a Star Wars game in the background. As if you couldn't tell. C-3PO. And then I've got enough for a child's sweater in this. I don't know, again, what this is. It feels kind of like Malabrigo or potentially Mano Zoroque. And then I'm going to pair it with a tan for the collar and stuff. So I think I'm going to make this into a Gramps cardigan for Joshua with a really nice caramel color for all the contrasting pieces. And then the last one is this one, which is Stargazer. So I have another sweater's quantity of this. Both of the sweater quantities are in vintage, which is the worsted weight. So I need to find some really good patterns for those. If you have any suggestions, I have, I think, 5 skeins each of these two that I can use for a sweater. So I'm in the market for some patterns. Cardigans or pullovers, I don't really have a preference. So that is what I have washed up so far. And then I also have 2 sweaters quantities of Broco Vintage, a sweaters quantity of Lamb's Pride Superwash Sport, and then a lot of various skeins of sock yarn. And I also have a Damson shawl that she had halfway knit. So I'm gonna try to do a gauge swatch and see if I can match her gauge and finish that off, because I think that'd be really special to have a shawl that she had partially knit and I finished. So that is all of my acquisitions that I got together to show you. I think there are some others, but I did not get them put together in time. So, otherwise, let's see. I've done some volunteering. So I finished up my junior achievement volunteering. I volunteered at a local place called Lifetown that does just helping students who have learning disabilities kind of learn to interact with just really basic life things that you would do. So there's a mock bank, a movie theater, dentist office, doctor's office. So it's all about, like, they go around, they make appointments, they have to show back up to complete those appointments, they have money that they have to budget, and they have different curriculum that they're doing over the course of the day. So I volunteered in the pet shop portion, which was probably the easiest gig. They didn't have a whole lot to sell, but it was very fun to see the kids interact with the animals. They had 2 bunnies, 2 guinea pigs, a tortoise, a snake, 2 parakeets, some fish. So yeah, it was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed it. And otherwise, I really haven't been doing a whole lot, just keeping my head above water at work and finishing out my moon square. So, yeah. And I did, Kristen was talking about words that she enjoys in other languages. So I said that my favorite word in Spanish is ardillita. I don't know why, but I really like it, and it just means little squirrel. And then I also really enjoyed learning tongue twisters in Spanish, because, you know, we do them in English all the time, so it's fun to see that other cultures do that as well. So I will leave you with my favorite tongue twister in Spanish, and I would love for all of you to share what your favorite tongue twisters are in other languages that you speak or know. So here we go. El volcán de Parangaricutirimícuaro lo quieren desparangaricutirimizar. El que lo desparangaricutirimice será un buen desparangaricutirimizador. Happy knitting, everyone, and I will see you next time. Bye.